Welcome everybody to Joanne.com. I'm your host Mikey on behalf of the crochet crowd representing this mystery crochet along with you. It is a stitch along adventure featuring Bernat blanket yarn. Are you ready to hook up something really amazing? I hope so, because today is clue number one. For today's mystery adventure, you need a total of 7 balls of Bernat blanket yarn. This is a 300 gram size. It's the large size format. You're gonna need a total of 4 colors, but listen, 3 of the colors need 2 balls and 1 color needs 1 ball. Think about your accent color when it considers that one of them only needs 1 ball of yarn. So just that's a kind of a little clue onto itself. So what you're going to need then is a size M 9mm crochet hook in order to play along as well today. When you're thinking about your colors for your particular project, just remember that Joanne.com online and the retail stores has some colors that are only found at Joanne.com. So when you're thinking about your decor and gift giving and etc., take a look at their colors because you may find colors that you never even knew existed that only live at Joanne.com. Just as a quick reminder that all patterns being used in today's video are available for free. In the video description of this tutorial, you will find a link that will directly take you there in order to access the free pattern. You should also know that if you would like to spoil your surprise and see what this clue looks like, you can scroll to the end of this video, but don't tell them I told you that. But if you would like to live on the edge and just hook along with me and be pleasantly surprised at the end, then you can do that too. So in the meantime, without further ado, let's dive into this mystery and let's start solving this together. So let's begin clue number one. And the first thing that we want to do is that we want to look at the diagram and the stitch key and work with them with the written instructions in order to put everything together. So this is what you're gonna find on the particular pattern, and this is the entire center area of your Afghan here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go through this step by step in order to make sure that you understand it, see how that these two work together, and then from here I'm then just going to jump to the actual physical work to show you what to do with each step. So in today's diagram we have rounds 1 all the way to round number 12. So this is where we're gonna stop our clue for today at the end of today's tutorial. So we're gonna be working in a round circle, and let me explain a little bit about this before we continue. So you'll notice that it's kind of like a pie shape. Well, the reason for this is that all of this, if they were to compress this all into one piece of paper, it would be a lot harder to read. So what they're showing you here in the beginning is that it is going all the way around, and even though that these are not going all the way around, you have to assume that is going all the way around and then coming back up, and it shows you really what you need to do in order to keep the repeat pattern going. So it really is key to see exactly where we're chaining up and then what we need to do to see a repeat pattern. And then once you understand the repeat pattern, you can go zip back around, and if you're zipping back around and you're keeping in the counts that it should, this is what it will look like when you come back up. So this is an actual representation of an entire circle. So the second thing is, what are these shapes? So these are the standard crochet diagram symbols. So what we have here is that any good diagram such as this has a stitch key that you can look and counter and just counter check back and forth. So me as an experienced crocheter, I can do this without having to look at this, but if you're new, this is a great way to tell what is going on. So ovals are the chains, dots are slip stitching, and dots are usually used in the beginning or ending of a project, and really quite easy. The plus signs or a cross are single crochets, and we see those right on number 12. We have a half double crochet, but I can tell you firsthand there is no half double crochet here. So you're gonna see some symbols here that are not on this chart. Why is that? Can't tell you. That might be a future clue. So this is a really kind of a cool concept to in order to work around. So if you're ever confused on what things mean, just go back to the stitch key and it will tell you exactly what you're looking at. So what I want to do is that I want to dive even further into this pattern, because from first glance you're gonna make some assumptions that may be incorrect. So let's do that next. So we have it starting in the middle, and we're gonna go around and then we're gonna build up, and these chaining of 3 counts as a double crochet in this particular pattern, and then we chain an extra one, so it'd be chaining of 4 and then double crochet into the next, and you continue to go in circles. Now upon first glance, when you get to the bigger areas, you're thinking, okay, double crochet, chain 1, skip 1, double crochet in the next one, chain 1, skip 1, and you start looking at it and you're thinking, oh, this is really quite simple. But what it's very easy to ignore or kind of like overlook is the idea that not all stitches are equal. So for example, see this one here? you will notice that there's a double crochet, chain one, and then double crochet into the next one. Yet the next one is a chain one, skip one, and double crochet in the next. So what I did for myself is that I started realizing that and I thought, okay, where else is that appearing? It appears here, here, and here. And why are they doing that? Well, the reason for that is that this pattern is progressively getting bigger. So they need to add more stitches in on an equal level to keep this circle from buckling up. So sometimes that they have to add in, and it's all incremental. So it's just, don't think that it's just random, because it's not. So what I want you to do is that I want you to look at this chart, which is, so in the neon yellow color, I highlighted when two stitches are in one. Okay, so you can see this going around, you can see that it's going into this one here, and you see it progressively. So these to me are the stages that are really trying to grow it out when you're on the rounds that are solid. So the ones that are having more of a gap space, that I highlighted the ones that are beside each other. So then it's skip one after that. And you'll notice right here in the end that there's two that are beside each other. And this is a great way to tell on the progressive on how it's getting bigger, as you can see. So you can almost see that in every round, it's very close to like spokes out of a wheel, that it's actually getting bigger near to the same points, except for the final kind of edge as we're going all the way around. So this is a kind of a neat concept. You can mark your chart any way you wish in order to, for you to understand it, but this is one thing that I like to do for myself in order to make it easier. So let's grab our size M, a 9mm crochet hook today, and in the center I'm going to be using Silver Steel by the Bernat Blanket yarn in order to complete most of the circle, except for the very final round where I'm going to use a vintage white. So here's what the sample looks like that we're going to be aiming for. The center is very solid, like so. Then we're gonna have a spacing kind of idea, and then solid and spacing and so on. So this is really kind of how it looks. So it's the same as the diagram when you're looking at it from either perspective, whether you're looking at it from a diagram point of view or the finished sample, it should look the same. Let's really grab our hook now. Let's grab our yarn and let's try your hand and see if you can get this. So let's begin with the slip knot. And we are going to chain four, and one of the stitches, the first one will be the center of your ring, and the other three will be a double crochet, and that'll make sense in just a moment. So please chain four. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And all I want you to do is wrap the hook and going into the very starting one, okay, it's the fourth one away from the hook, so 1, 2, 3, and 4, it's the very start. And I want you to put in 13 double crochets into that same one. So you got 1, and you're gonna have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, 8, 9, and 10. We have 11, 12, and 13. So with that chaining of four that you started with, is that there should be a total of 14 posts going around. So let's just count those together. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. Once you have that satisfied, all I want you to do is just insert your hook into the top of the first chain, four chain that you started with, and then just join it with the slip stitch like this. And this is the center ring of your Afghan. Let's move along to the second round. So there's a total of 14 of these going all the way around, and we're going to incrementally increase as we go. So number two, we want to chain four. So 1, 2, 3, there's your double crochet, and the fourth one is a chain one. So it's a double crochet and chain one. So you're gonna come immediately to the next stitch, and you're going to double crochet, and then chain one, and then coming into the next stitch, double crochet, and then chain one, and continue all the way around in order to make this work. Okay, so chain one, double crochet into the next, chain one, double crochet in the next, and I'll see at the end of this round, which is round number two. I'm coming up all the way around and I've just double crocheted into the last stitch that's available, but before you finish off this one you should chain one first and then join it to the third chain up. Remember we chained up four, so 1, 2, 3. Go to the third chain up only. Don't go all the way to the fourth one because that'll eliminate that one chain space that you want. So when you go to count these you should have 14 of these spokes going all the way around. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. If you don't have 14 you need to stop right now. Just take a look at your work and see where you're going wrong and then continue on with round number 3. So round number 3 we're going to chain up 3 and then there's gonna be 2 double crochets into the chain 1 space and then a double crochet into this double crochet and you're gonna continue that same idea all the way around. So every chain 1 space will get 2 and then every double crochet will get 1 double crochet and you're gonna work yourself all the way back around and you're gonna join it. So let me show you how to do that. Let's begin round number 3. So round number 3 we're going to chain up 3. So 1, 2, 3 and that counts as the double crochet leading from this double crochet spoke. That just kinda helps you get your orientation. So in number 3 every chain 1 space is gonna get 2 double crochets inside. So we're just gonna go right into the space itself and double crochet 2 times into that same space. So 1 and 2. The next double crochet that's available to you is just gonna be 1 double crochet inside that double crochet. Then you're back to a chain 1 space. So in the chain 1 space then 2 double crochets. Please do that idea all the way around for round number 3. So I'm coming all the way back around. I've got my double crochet in this double crochet. I've just got a chain 1 space left and that's gonna have 2 double crochets inside as per the pattern of course. And then we're just going to join it with a slip stitch to the top of the beginning chain 3 to finish like so. So you can see that this round kind of made it more flat. The other round was starting to buckle up but you can see that the rounds kind of really work together. Then one will kind of make it all kind of funky and then the other one will settle it down. So don't lose any patience when it comes to anything like that. Let's move along to round number 4. So let's move along to round number 4. So you're gonna chain up a total of 4. So this is a double crochet and a chain 1 and then in the next double crochet you're going to double crochet then chain 1, skip 1, double crochet in the next, chain 1 and then double crochet in the next. So I have highlighted it with the fuchsia like this just to show you the fact that they're kind of working right directly beside each other even though that there's a chain 1 space that separates them and this is allowing round number 4 to get bigger by inserting an extra chain into the in between the double crochets. Let's move along to number 4. Let me show you how to do it. So let's begin round number 4. We're gonna chain up 4. 1, 2, 3. There's your double crochet and an extra chain which is your fourth is your chain 1. You're gonna come right to directly to the next double crochet right beside it and you are going to double crochet into that space. So the repeat pattern for this whole thing is that right now you're going to then chain 1, okay? You're going to skip 1 and then go into the next for a double crochet. Chain 1, go directly to the next double crochet. I'll show you that again. Okay? So you're going to chain 1, skip 1 double crochet and double crochet into the second one over, chain 1 and double crochet into the next one just like it shows in the pattern. So chain 1, skip 1, go to the second one over just like that, chain 1 and then just double crochet into the next one and continue that same pattern going all the way around. So I'm coming up all the way back around. I'm right to the one just before I need to finish. I need to chain 1 and I need to join it to the third chain up not the fourth. Remember that so you can keep that. So how do you know if you've done it right so far? That each one of these two if you look at them as like pairs like because they're directly beside each other there should be 14 pairs. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and continue that and I have verified that off camera. So this is what it looks like at this moment and let's move along to round number 5. So round number 5 is when we're gonna incrementally start getting bigger. We're gonna start kind of creating these spoke lights coming out and we're gonna start creating spaces in between that are just regular stitches instead of doubling them up. So we're going to chain 3 which counts as a double crochet and then the next 2 are just 2 double crochets in a row and then the next space then has 2 into the same space and then the next 3 are into the double crochet, chain 1 and double crochet and then the next one is in 2. So I looked at it from the perspective that essentially every these pairs that you are working with, it's the space in between where two pairs are coming together is where I'm gonna be looking for visually, but I need to count that out as well. So you gotta go 1, 2, 3 and then 2 into the next, 1, 2, 3, 2 into the next. And so you'll be doing those right into the chain one spaces. So if you're ever thinking that you're losing count and you're thinking that you gotta put 2 into a top of a double crochet, you know that you're going off the rails. Let's begin round number 5. So let's begin round number 5. So look at these two as a pair, okay? So there's a pair here. Even though they're directly beside each other, they kinda look like they're a pair. And so we're gonna be playing with adding those double stitches where the two into the same one in between these pairs. So that's a pair, this is a pair, so I'd have to be adding it here. So here's a pair, here's a pair, so the extra is right in between. So just keep that in mind for visual. So we're gonna chain up 3, 1, 2, 3 and that counts as a double crochet. Gonna go right into the chain one space for a double crochet. We're gonna go to the next double crochet for a double crochet, and there's your 3 that stand alone, and then the next one, which is the space in between the pairs, okay, that is gonna have 2 double crochets, and that's gonna happen every time we hit one of those. So this is where we're gonna get bigger in the increments. So the next 3 are by themselves, so just go right to the next double crochet. So 1, go to the next chain one space, that's 2, go to the next double crochet, that's your 3. So here's one pair, here's another, and again, see it's right in the middle, and you're gonna add your 2 double crochets into that same idea. Continue that same pattern going all the way around, so it's just 3 in a row. So 1, and this chain one space for 2, double crochet for 3, and then here is the space again that is in between the pairs, which is gonna get 2 double crochets. Please do that all the way around, just like that. So I'm coming up to the end of round number 5. The final chain one space is there, and there's 2 double crochets into that space. I ended up there by the calculation of the pattern anyway, but you should make sure that you end up there. So if you end up here and you're not in the same kind of counts of 3 by themselves and then 2 into the one, that you know something is wrong. So let's just join it to the beginning top of the chain 3, and that concludes round number 5. So I'm back to the chart for round number 6. So we're gonna chain up 4, 3 of it counts as double crochet and then a chain 1. We skip 1 and double crochet in the next, chain 1, skip 1, double crochet in the next, chain 1, and double crochet into the very next one. So where I've highlighted is where 2 double crochets are sitting beside each other when it comes to this, and so you can see the increments as it grows as well. So let's move along to round number 6. Moving along to round number 6, we're gonna chain up 4. So 1, 2, 3, there's your double crochet, and the 4th is your chain 1. So in this particular one, we want to skip the next stitch that's available to you, the next double crochet, and come to the second one over and double crochet into that, double crochet. Just like that. Chain 1, and we want to skip over the next double crochet and double crochet into the second one over. And here's the increment of growth on the, this particular point. So we're gonna chain 1 right there, and then just double crochet right into the very next one, so we're not skipping anything at this particular point. So let's repeat on how to do this particular one again. So I'm going to chain 1, I'm gonna skip 1 and go to the second over. I'm going to chain 1, skip 1, go to the second chain over, and this is the where the growth is gonna happen, so chain 1 after this, and then come right directly beside for another double crochet. So it's just like the pattern shows, is that you have 2 that are pretty close to each other side by side, and you have 1 that's kind of just standing on its own. So continue that all the way for round number 6. So I'm coming up all the way around in number 6. So I have to basically at this point I have to skip 1 and go into the final. This is the final stitch that is available, and then I chain 1 and then I slip stitch to the 3rd chain up. So this final one, if you looked at the diagram, they were kind of just side by side, which they are, and so then you have 1 that stands by itself and then side by side and so on. So that was round number 6. Let's move on to number 7. Moving up to round number 7, we're gonna chain up 3, which counts as a double crochet, and the next 4 double crochets are in a row. So there's gonna be a total of 5 double crochets in between the increments of growth. The nice thing about this is that you see where we put two side by side with the chain one space in the middle, you can really identify that on this pattern. It's really quite easy. And so you can really think about it. The space that's separating those two is the space that's gonna have the growth. Do you see that? These ones were sitting by itself. So use that as a clue in order for you to help. And I think this particular pattern is really quite easy in this particular round because all I have to do is look where they are and it just makes a lot of sense. So let's move along to round number 7. So moving along to round number 7, and so do you see that these two are sitting by itself, are beside each other? So those are the ones that's gonna have the two in there. This one's kind of on its own. Do you see that? When you really look at it. So these two are side by side and these two are side by side, these are on its own. So this is where we're going to put those two extra in. So let's begin and we're going to chain up 3. So 1, 2, and 3, and we come into the next chain one space for a double crochet. And remember there's gonna be 5 in a row. So let's start counting those as we go. So the chaining of 3 counts as one of the double crochets. So we're physically on number 2 for the count. Double crochet for the third, the space for the 4th, just like this. And in this double crochet then is your 5. So there's your 5 to satisfy it. Look where you are. The next one is right in between where the two sit side by side. There's gonna be 2 double crochets right into that same space. Just like that. So now there's gonna be another 5 before you get to this one right here where they're sitting side by side. Use those visual clues. It's a lot easier. So let's count up 5. So 1, go to the chain one space next for 2, double crochet into the next double crochet for 3, chain one space for 4, and the next double crochet is your 5th, and look where exactly where you are again. See, you're right in between where the two are side by side. So you put in 2 double crochets into that same space. Please do that for round number 7. So I'm coming up to the end of round number 7. Remember the final chain one space, see how these two are side by side, is going to be the one that has 2 together or 2 into the same one. And so that just helps you, give you a visual clue as well. So join it to the top of the chain 3 that you started with, and we're going to then move on with round number 8. Like so. Okay, so it's looking really good so far. I'm really quite happy with it. Let's move along. I'm so excited. So let's go on to round number 8. We're gonna chain up 4, 3 of it counts as a double crochet, and then we're gonna skip one stitch, double crochet in the next. Chain 1, skip one stitch, double crochet in the next. Chain 1, skip one stitch, and then look, these two are side by side with a chain 1 that separates them. So there's gonna be chain 1s obviously that separate each one of the double crochets. So my visual cue on this one is that every time I see that there was 2 into the same one, because you physically can see that on your pattern, is that that is the start of one coming in, chain 1, and then double crochet into the very next one right after it. So use these as your visual cues as you're going all the way around, and let's begin round number 8. So let's begin round number 8. We're gonna chain 4. So 1, 2, 3, there's your double crochet. The 4th is your chain 1 space. So skip the next one and go to the second one over for a double crochet. Chain 1, skip 1, double crochet in the next one. So here is the 2 that are standing by themselves. Chain 1 and skip 1 and look. See how these 2 are into the same one? So I told you as we did it, so the second one is the one that we end up with the double crochet, chain 1, and we double crochet directly beside it for the next one. So there's your incremental increase. Okay, so this one here, that chaining of 3 that you have right here at the beginning, is actually one of these that are side by side. So let's repeat this pattern again just so you understand. So you're gonna chain 1, skip 1, double crochet in the next. You're going to chain 1, skip 1, double crochet in the next. So here's your 2 that stand all lonely by themselves. Chain 1, skip 1, and look at that. See, it's the second one of where 2 are into the same one. You're gonna double crochet into that one, chain 1, and double crochet directly into the next one that's available to you, so you don't skip over anything at that point. Do you see that? So there you got your lonely ones here. You got the ones that are still looking like they're sitting side by side, which they are, and a chain 1 space separates them. And so then 2 lonelies, and then 2 side by sides. So continue that same idea going all the way around. So I'm coming up all the way around at number 8. So I got 2 lonelies that are here, chain 1, and I skip 1, and I double crochet into the next one, which is the final stitch, chain 1, and then just join it to the 3rd one up. Okay, so this beginning one and the final are the ones that kind of look like that they're sit like 2 beside each other. Okay, so that's it for number 8. Let's move on to round number 9. So let's move up to number 9. We're gonna chain 3, which counts as a double crochet, and we're gonna double crochet 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So with this one here, it's a total of 7 double crochets in between the ones that have the incremental increase. You notice this? Yes, those are the ones that are sitting side by side. So these ones sit directly in between those. So if you can look for those cues, which are really easy to tell, you can really be able to follow and whip along in this round really quite easily as well. This pattern is a lot easier than I realized when you just take it step by step instead of trying to digest it all at one time. So 7 in a row and then 2 into the next, and then just look for your visual cues of where the ones that are side by side to put those in when you see it. So you'll be ending with 2 into that last chain 1 space, just like you see here, and then just joining it. Let's begin round number 9. So let's begin number 9. So when you really look at it, see the 2 that are sitting side by side? Very easy to tell that is the one that's gonna have the 2 in there. So you keep moving along, you got 2 lonelies, hey, there's one side by side, that'll be where the next increase is. But you can count it out as well. So we're gonna chain up 3, 1, 2, 3, and do 6 of its buddies. So chain 1 into the next space. So let's count those out. Let's count it out with that chain 3 counters. So this is number 2, this is number 3, chain 1 space for 4, double crochet into the next double crochet for 5, chain 1 space for 6, and double crochet for 7, and look exactly where you are. See? It's the one that are side by side. So the next one will have 2 double crochets sitting right in the middle of those 2. Just like that. So let's do another 7. So 7 in a row. So 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And look where we are. See? You got 2 side by side, so that right in the space in between is the one that has 2. Please do that all the way around for round number 9. So as you come back around the chain 1 space just before, it has 2 in there, and that's keeping with the count of the stitches, so that's no accident. Of course we're keeping in balance, and then you're just going to join it to the top of the beginning, chain 3, to conclude round number 9. So this is what we have so far. Let's move along and go for round number 10. So moving up to round number 10, we're gonna chain 4, 3 of it counts as a double crochet, and then we're gonna skip 1, double crochet in the next, chain 1. And what you're doing here, do you notice here? You had 1 lonely one, then you had 2 lonely ones, now you got 3 lonely ones, and so you're just gonna carry on. Just like the visual clue with how these were in together, and it was the second one, just like you see, you put in 2 in the last one there, it's again the second one is your visual cue on which ones go side by side. So in this case what we're going to do is that we're just gonna have 3 lonely ones. Remember that the chain 3 counts as one that's side by side as you're in here, as you're working all the way around. So let's begin round number 10. Round number 10, we're going to chain up 4. So 1, 2, 3, that is your double crochet, the 4th is your chain 1. So skipping the next stitch and going to the second one over, you're going to double crochet, and we're gonna create 3 lonely ones all by themselves of double crochet. Chain 1, skip 1, double crochet into the next. Okay, chain 1, skip 1, double crochet into the next. So now here's your 3 lonely ones, because this one here is part of one that sits side by side. So when you chain 1, and you're gonna go to the second one over, so there, see? This is where the 2 are in there, and it's the last one of the 2. It's the second one, right? So that is just like it was before. So chain 1 and double crochet immediately into the next one. And there's your increase for that one. So let's again repeat this pattern. So chain 1, skip 1, double crochet in the next. So yep, there we go. And chain 1, skip 1, double crochet in the next. Chain 1, skip 1, double crochet in the next. There's your 3 lonely ones in there. Chain 1, skip 1, and look at that. See, you're in the second one of where there's 2 into the same one. Means that we're on the right path. Chain 1, and double crochet immediately into the very next one. Please continue that same idea going all the way around for round number 10. So I'm coming up all the way around. I got three lonely ones right in a row right here, and now I'm gonna chain one and skip one and go to the final, which these two count as side by side, chain one and just join it to the top, or sorry, to the third chain up, just like so. So that concludes off round number 10. So you can see clearly you got the ones that stand by themselves here, you got the ones that sit side by side, and so on all the way around. Let's move up to round number 11. So we're almost done the circle for today, and what we have here is that we need to chain up three, and then we're gonna do another 12 in a row. So there's gonna be a total, if with this chaining three counts as a double crochet, there's gonna be a total of 13 double crochets standing by itself, and then the next one is going to be two into the next. So the way that I look at it here is that this one, I don't see any visual cues that really can help me at this particular point. So I'm gonna physically need to count these all the way around. So there's 13 double crochets in between each one of these ones that sit side by side, and this will conclude then basically this. And we're gonna finish off this color at this point and finish round number 12 with a different color in order to bring this one to conclusion. So let's begin round number 11. We're gonna chain up three, one, two, three, that counts as a double crochet. You're gonna double crochet into the double crochets and chain one spaces as you go, and then you need to count a total of 12 additional. So with this one here, it's 13. So let's count it with this one included so it makes it easier to follow along. So the next one then will be two, and you're just filling in all the spaces and double crochets. This is three and four and five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, and 13. So there's your 13 just like so, and so then you end up with the chain one spaces being your next one, which is accurate as per the pattern, and there will be two double crochets into that same space. And then we start back up 13 again. So let me do another 13 with you. So we're gonna just start immediately in the next double crochet. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. And the next one is a chain one space, and that one has your two in there. So you'll put two in that one then, and continue that same pattern all the way around. So 13 in a row, then two, 13 in a row, and then two. Please do that all the way around for round number 11. So I'm coming up all the way back around. Here's the final chain one space, and there's two double crochets into that same space, and that keeps in line with the count as well. So that was my 14th one. So I did 13 in a row, and here's the two. And then I'm just going to join it with the beginning, top of the beginning chain in three. That's it for this particular color. We're going to switch off colors for number 12 and then conclude the circle for today. So let me finish off this color. So I've already trimmed it, so it's about 10 inches long, and I'm just gonna pull it through the remaining loop. What I want to do, taking my hook, I want to just feed it in and out of these stitches for at least a couple inches. And what we're gonna do in the next round is that we've got one more color and round to do for this particular area, and then that color is gonna wrap around this, so it's gonna be quite nice to go in there. And overall, I think you'll enjoy this project generally. The finished project looks amazing. Not gonna lie, it's gonna look awesome. So let's continue and let's move up to round number 12. So right where I ended, there was two that were in the same one, and here's the chain three of the one of round number 11. So I wanna stick my hook in there, and I want to grab my new yarn. I do not wanna create a knot, I just wanna loop it around, and I wanna pull through, and just let this straggler just fall down on top, and I want you to chain up one and one single crochet into that same stitch that you just put it in. So now we're going to count out stitches together. So the next one, see there's a chain one space. So the next one is then each double crochet as you work around. So this one plus the other 13 gives you a total 14. So I'm gonna count this one in, okay? So the next one is going to, and just put this down on top. The next one is 2. The next one is 3. And 4. And I just wanna bury that whole section in. This is 5. 6. 7. And 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. And look at that. See, there's 2 into the same one, and it's the second one of the 2, just like it shows in the diagram, is gonna have 2 single crochets. So continue the same idea, 14 in a row, and then 2, 14 in a row, and then 2. Please do that all the way around, and then we're gonna fasten off, and then this is the conclusion of the circle part of the Afghan. So I'm coming all the way back around. I have 1 stitch left, and I've even keeping count, and that is the one that has 2 in there. So I've done my 14 before that, and that's the one with 2, and just join it to the top of the beginning single crochet. That's it for this color, and that concludes this part of the Afghan. Just fasten this color off, and then you can join me next time in order to be able to follow along with the rest of this Afghan. So please just weave in and out your yarn and get ready, and we'll meet you back here, and we'll begin to do the next section of this particular Afghan. So that's it for now. Looks like you got a little bit of homework. Better get it done before you see me next Monday, where I'm gonna take you to clue number 2. This is a great way to do more Afghans at the same time if you do it in sections like this. So if you wanna start another one or another or another, of course you're welcome to do so, because it's not as daunting when you do it in stages like this. Of course, we wanna see your work. Joanne, Facebook, we have an events page happening where the stitchers of knitters and crocheters are coming together showing their work in progress. Maybe you have some really cool color schemes. Maybe you have some questions. Remember, if you're tagging us on Instagram, please use our hashtag of Handmade with Joanne. That's Handmade with Joanne, and we love to be tagged in order to see your work. So on behalf of joanne.com, I'm your host Mikey of the Crochet Crowd. Thank you so much for joining us, and we'll see you again next week for clue number 2. See ya. Welcome back to joanne.com. I'm your host Mikey of the Crochet Crowd, going for clue number 2, which is week number 2 of the Bernat Blanket Stitch Along, where we're taking an Afghan project and making it really cool, because you really don't know what you're working on until the very end. That's why it's a mystery. So today we are going to clue number 2. Last week, if you missed that, just go back and see the last video and pattern, and you can access that at any time in order to be able to follow along. Then you can join us back here, and then we can work on it together. But we won't tell anybody that you missed week 1. It's between us. So what we're going to do is, in week number 2, last week you did a beautiful circle. So what's gonna happen this time? Can't tell you, but if you do scroll to the end of this video, you can get a preview to see what you're going to be doing. But if you like to live dangerously and on the edge, of course, just stay with right here. Don't forward ahead, and be pleasantly surprised at the end. Choice is up to you. So that's it for me gabbing in front of the camera. Let's go down to the studio right now, and let's begin our clues for week number 2. So let's move along in clue number 2. So far we have this done. It's a circle with a nice little border around, and mine is a different color, so it looks completely different, and it's amazing how the colors can make that big of a difference. So what we want to do is, if you haven't got this done, please backtrack, go to back to clue number 1 and do this first before moving on in today's tutorial. Today's tutorial, we're going to break down all of the particular steps that are involved, and that's regarding reading the chart and doing the stitch work. So let's move along. So when I last left you, we did clue number 1, and we did this circle, and I had it all marked out for you as you saw. So now we're going to move on, and we're going to do this here. And so we're gonna convert the circle into a massive square. So we're gonna lay it down on top, and just as a demonstration, you'll see that this, the slip stitching lines up perfectly. Now you'll see this is going off into the rails a little bit. You should just know that this is a more of a large version of this, and so therefore it doesn't align properly in the paper, but it lines perfectly on the sample itself. So what we want to do is that we wanna move up, and we want to look at this particular item. So here's your circle that's in the center. The grayed out plus signs here. Those are single crochets. You've already done that. That's number 12 as it states up here. And then what we want to do is that we want to do a total of 7 more rounds. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 to bring this whole circle into a beautiful square at the end of this tutorial. So let's go through the stitch work. This looks a lot more complicated than it is. Of course, I had to pull up my highlighters and I'm gonna show you what to look for. Well, you know me by now, I like to mark up my charts, and here we go. This is what it looks like, and this is my version here. Isn't that pretty? I should get some awards for that. So what I want you to notice is that I have highlighted the single crochets, which are plus symbols. And if you're just joining us for the first time, you should know that all of these particular symbols are available on a stitch key, and it tells you all this stuff that you need to know. Now you're gonna see stuff on this stitch key that are currently not on here. I guess that's coming ahead. You'll have to stay tuned and watch for that. So what we want to do is that we wanna look at the plus signs, which are the single crochets. Wanna look at the half double crochets. We wanna look at the double crochets, which I never highlighted, and then trebles. Okay, those are treble crochet. So you're going to notice on this particular sample is that what happens on one side of the square happens identically on the next and on the next. The only difference here on this top one is that this is where we're going to carry on this the slip stitch. So essentially you have your chaining up. This is how we move up. So this is happening on here. So why don't they show you the entire square? Well, the reason for that, if you're not familiar with these kind of ideas, is that because it's a mirror image, everything happening on this side that you cannot see is showing right here. And everything happening on this side right here is showing right here. It's just showing you how to get started, what one side looks like without a slip stitch, and how it carries around as to show you the corners. So you have to just be very conscious of that. So let's just take a look at the stitch counts and see what is unique about this pattern. So let's take a look at the stitch counts, and I highlighted certain critical areas that I would need for myself, so you can have the advantage of being in my brain for 2 minutes. So what we have here is I've got the single crochets. In single crochets there's 11 in the first round, 13 in the second, 17 in the third. And if you kindly look at it, you can kind of see that in the second round here, it expands over the half double crochet, so you can see that it's getting bigger, and then there's more and more just like you see. So because it's getting bigger towards the point here, there's going to be an expansion towards the corners, and so then you're seeing that as well. So what's happening on one side is happening on the other, which is happening on the other and the other, just like that. So here what it looks like without any slip stitching, because this is where you're going to join it and then move up to the next round. And so you can see that again there's 11, 13, and 17. So then I looked at the half double crochets. So half double crochets on all of them, which you can see in the fuchsia, is 5 and 5 and 5 and 5 and 5 and 5 all the way for round number 1. Round number 2 was it was 6, just like that, okay? And number 3 was 8 half double crochets in a row. So it just makes a lot of sense that when you're going all the way around for this idea is that you're kind of keeping an eye on the counts. I also looked at the double crochet. I never highlighted it because I didn't have another marker, but you can just see that in round number 1 we have 5, round number 2 we have 6, and round number 3 we have 7. I never counted the corners when I did all of these counts, so I said that the corners are not included. I also then looked at the trebles. How many trebles are in a row without being in a corner? And so then in round number 1 there's 4. See? There's 4 on both sides of the corner. And I never included the corners on that. And then in the round number 2 there's 3. So 1, 2, 3. And that's how I looked at it from this perspective. Once we get beyond round number 3, it gets then really quite simple. So what you're noticing right here is that we're getting really taller stitches in order to bring this big large circle into a square shape, and that's exactly what we're trying to go for. So I know this is a long description, but I think that if you understand this chart, and once you get beyond number 3, it gets a lot easier from that point as well. So we're gonna start round number 1, and where we're gonna start is that we're going to really look at it from a perspective of where you finished off. I can be quite honest with you, with this particular one, it doesn't matter where you start on this particular circle. It's all gonna be balanced out anyway, because the stitch counts that are gonna go all the way around this are gonna balance the circle anyway. So you can either choose to start exactly where you left off, or you can just be somewhere else in the circle. For the first time around, it doesn't matter because you'll end up in back and balance, but then from that point you'll have your your slip stitching working out. So it actually looks really quite decent, and because it's a full circle, it really doesn't make a difference. That's a completely your call. To stay true to the designer, I'm gonna start exactly where I stopped. So there's gonna be two in a row, and then there's gonna be the one where I started. So when I look at it here, I got my two in a row, and here's exactly where I started. So this is my starting point right here, and I'm gonna start off with teal and begin round number one. So let's start off, and I'm going to not create a slip knot. I'm just gonna create a loop, just like you see in my hand here. And I'm gonna go into the very first one that we had started with before. So this is where I ended, and that's where I wanna pull that through. So pull that through, and we're going to then begin our next step. So leave the straggler down on top so that it gets stuck underneath like we've done before. And I want you to chain one, and we're going to single crochet into that same one plus four more of its friends across the way. So we got one, and then we'll move on to the next one for two. Just make sure this stays on top so you don't have to sew that in later. And three, four, and five. Okay, so with the slip stitching that you started with plus four, that gives you a total of five. So let's move along. We're going to carry on with the half double crochets, and there's gonna be five half double crochets in a row. So wrapping the hook first, going in. So you got one, we got two, three, four, and five. So now we're gonna move on to the double crochet. So the double crochet, there's gonna be five in a row. So the next five are all going to be double crochets. So one, two, three, four, and five. So you can see the stitches are getting taller as it's compensating for the bend of the circle. So now we're gonna move on to trebles, and now there's gonna be four trebles in a row. So we're gonna wrap the hook twice, going into the next stitch, and we're gonna do four of these trebles. So one, and then moving into the next one, two, okay, do it again for three, do it again for four. And now the very next one is a corner. So in the corners, they're always the same for this particular round, is that there's gonna be two trebles, two chains, two trebles, all within the same stitch. So we're gonna wrap the hook twice, going into the next stitch. We're gonna do two trebles into that same stitch, just like that, chain two, and then two more trebles back into that same stitch once again. So there's a lot going on in that one stitch to start creating the corner look. Okay, so you've officially just turned your corner, so you can see how you're getting bigger and bigger, and let's turn our work and let's begin to go up the other side. So let's begin to go up a full side without any slip stitching involved. So we're gonna treble into the first four. So you got one, two, three, and four. Okay, so you see that going on. And now let's move on. We're gonna do five double crochets in a row. So the next five are double crochets. So one, two, three, four, and five. And now we're gonna move on to half double crochets. There's gonna be five half double crochets next. So you got one, oops, that was one, try that again. You got two, three, four, and five. And now we're gonna move on to single crochet. So you see that you're getting smaller and smaller back into the corner, or sorry, back into the flat edge. So there's gonna be 11 single crochets in a row. So we got one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, and 11. So now we're officially and then ready to go back bigger again. So there's gonna be 5 half double crochets in a row. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, and now we're gonna do double crochets. There's gonna be 5 double crochets in a row. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And now we're moving on to trebles. So if you remember, there was 4 trebles in a row. So let's start doing that. So 1, I'm actually already remembering this pattern. It's great. So this is 2. We have 3 and 4. And now the next one is the corner, just like we had before. So let me show you how to do a corner one more time. So you're gonna wrap the hook going into the next stitch, and you're gonna do 2 trebles into the same stitch. So back into the same stitch again, chain 2 for the top. So 1, 2, back in the same stitch then again for 2 more trebles. So what I want you to do at this point is that I want you to either carry on as per the instructions, or just reverse this video and take yourself back to where you had started over here, and it will take you back across the top. And when I come back, I'm going to meet you back when we're going to join it to the slip stitch, and I'll just show you how to finish off. This is round number 1. So as you come up all the way back around, I wanna show you a little secret that I did. So I'm off by 1 stitch, and I've double counted, and I am off by 1. So I never counted before I started the ring. So what I did is that I did 2 together single crochets right here, and this will make sure that 2 just became 1, and it's really not gonna be noticeable at the end of the day with this kind of thing. So instead of frogging everything back out, if you're off like that, no big deal. Just make sure that you did get all your stitch counts right. So now I am left with my 6 that I need. I had 7, that's why I did that. And I'm going to put in my single crochets for 6 in a row. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and just this is where we started, 6. So then we want to just join it to the top of the first single crochet that we finished with, just like that. So now you've just gone all the way across, and you now got the startings of your corners just like so. So it's not yet complete a corner like a square, for example. So we're gonna then carry on for round number 2, and we're gonna make this more square as we go. So let's move up to round number 2. We're going to chain 1 single crochet into the same one, and this time there will be 6 single crochets before then we start the half doubles. Half doubles, if you remember, in round number 2 there will be 6 in a row. In the double crochets there will be 6 in a row, and then in the trebles we're going to reduce down, and there will only be 3 and then a corner. So then it starts up the other side again, 3 trebles in a row, and the double crochets there will be a total of 6. There will be 6 half double crochets just like so, and there's gonna be more single crochets along this side. There's gonna be a total of 13, and we're gonna continue to do that all the way around. So please do that, and I will see you in just a second. So let's begin. We're going to chain 1 and single crochet into the same one, and that it counts as one of them. So we need to do a total of 6. So if that includes 1, so that's 1 moving along. We got 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now we're gonna carry on for half double crochets, and this time there will be a total of 6 in a row. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Just like that. And then what you can do then is then we're gonna do double crochets, and this time there will be a total of 6. There will be a total of 6 double crochets in a row. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and we have a total of 6. And now we're going to move on to the trebles. So there's gonna be a total of 3 trebles in a row, and look, you only have 3 trebles anyway to work with. Do you see that? So that kind of gives you your clue as well. So we're gonna do three trebles in a row. So 1, 2, and 3. So this is growing the corners out even more. So in the corner, the chain two space, this time there will be two trebles into that same space. So 1, and we have 2. Followed by a chain two like before, 1 and 2, and then trebles back in for 2 more into that same space. So now a corner is done. So now I'm gonna show you what it looks like to go all the way down one side. So you can see we got smaller here as towards the top, and then we're getting bigger to compensate for the circle going around. Let's move along and I'm gonna show you one complete side. So let's do one complete side together, and you can reverse the video then to restart the next sides if you need to. So you're going to do, the first three are going to be trebles. So 1, 2, and 3. So now we're gonna move on to double crochets. There will be a total of 6. So 6 in a row for doubles. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. There's gonna be 6 half double crochets next. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And now there's gonna be 13 single crochets in a row. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. Now there's gonna be 6 half double crochets next. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. There's gonna be 6 double crochets next. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and look at that. So you got 3 trebles left. Do you see that? So then those are gonna be trebles this time. So 1, 2, and 3, and now you're back on a corner. Corners are always gonna be the same in this particular one, so we're going to do 2 trebles into the corner, chain 2 space, chain 2, and 2 trebles in. Just like that. So that's what you're gonna end up with, and so you can reverse this video. You can see now you've gotten more from the narrow and you've gotten bigger as you're starting to do this turn, and this is starting to look more and more like a square. Please do the remainder of the sides, and I'll meet you at the end of this rotation when we decide to do the slip stitch together. So in completing round number 2, I've just got my 6 half double crochets in there. I had 6 double crochets. I had my 3 trebles in there right back to the corner, and now I'm left with a total of 7 stitches left over for my last single crochet. So let's do that together. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And join it to the top of the beginning single crochet to finish that round for round number two. So that's what it looks like. It's getting closer to a square. It's not quite yet there. We still have to do one more round in order to make it completely square, and then moving on to that from that point. So moving up to round number three, we're gonna chain up one single crochet into the next eight. Okay, so we got that includes that one. So you have eight in a row, half double crochets on the third one is there's gonna be eight, and then we have double crochets on the third one. There's gonna be a total of seven, and there's no more trebles. That's it. So the seven does not include the corner. I never included that when I did that, so it says corner not included. So then we're gonna come around then, and we're gonna have again double crochets in a row. You're gonna have seven, and then you're gonna have eight half double crochets as you come, and then this right here, you're gonna have a total of 17 single crochets, and then you're gonna repeat the pattern all the way around. So let's begin round number three. Start round number three, we're gonna chain up one, and you're going to single crochet into the first one, and you're going to join its buddies there. So there's gonna be a total of eight in a row, so including that one, let's count that one in already. So the next ones are gonna be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So moving on, let's do half double crochets. There's gonna be a total of 8 in a row. Let's do that one. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, and you're getting closer to the corner. Now we're gonna have double crochets left. We have a total of 7 in a row. That does not include the corner. So let's do 7. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. It takes you to the one right before, and now you got your corner. So in your corner, what you're going to do for every one of the corners for this round is that there's gonna be a total of 2 double crochets into the corner. So 1 and 2, followed by chain 2, and then 2 more double crochets into the same corner. So I'm gonna begin working down the side, doing a full side with you, and then you can do the rest of the sides on your own, and we'll meet back at the end. And you can see this is actually now gone from almost a circle into a complete square. Let's begin one full side together. So now that you got a full square done, so now that you got a full corner done, we're gonna move down the side. So there's, let's begin, we're gonna do 7 double crochets first in a row. So starting in the first one, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Now we're gonna move to half double crochets. There's gonna be a total of 8 this time in a row. So let's do that. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4. So that was 5, 6, 7, and 8. And now there's gonna be a total of 17 single crochets in a row. So let's do that. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17. Just want to double check that. Just coming along. And we have, there you go, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. And after this round, the counts really don't matter too much for being this accurate, for having to count everything around. So this is the last time you're gonna have to really be that concentrating on the counts for this particular clue. So let's begin again. So we're gonna do 8 half double crochets. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I just want to count that again. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And now we have 7 double crochets in a row. I'm starting to remember this pattern. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And that takes you to the corner, just like there. So your corner is your next. So it's gonna be 2 double crochets. So 1 and 2. Chain 2 and back into the same corner for another 2. Please do that all the way around. Just, you can reverse this last side if you want to, if you need to reminder what to do. And this is kind of what it's looking like now, and it's actually looking really quite cool. So let's continue along, and I'll see you at the end of this round. I've now circled most of the way around, and I'm coming back to where I've done the slip stitching. So I've done my half double crochets. There was a total of 8 in a row, and then 7 double crochets, and then the corners, just like we had over here. So the final on this one here is going to be 9 single crochets in a row. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And look at that, it takes you right back, and then just join it to the beginning single crochet. So this is what, it's now almost a full square, if not quite, and it just stretch a little bit, but you've got almost the whole square look. So we've gone from a circle transition here to a beautiful square. So now we're just gonna continue on with rounds 4, 5, 6, and 7 for this particular area of the clue. And now the major counting is pretty much done for this. Going from a circle to a square like this requires a lot of counting in order to get the square shape back out of this. So let's move along to round number 4. So here we have the chart once again. So round number 4, you can see it's 1 double crochet in each stitch all the way, and in the corners it's just 2 into the corner, chain 2, and then 2 back into the corner, and just 1 double crochet in each. So you don't really physically have to count. As long as your counts have been right all the way to this point, you can just simply zip around. Remember that the chain 3 that you start off with counts as a double crochet in this case, so you're going to slip stitch it to this area here, to the top of the chain 3, when you come all the way back around. So round number 4 is nice and easy. It's chaining a 3 that counts as your double crochet, which counts as the first stitch moved to the second over. Okay, and just double crochet in each stitch now going all the way around. Now on the corners, make sure that what I just talked about is 2 double crochets in the corner followed by chain 2 and 2 double crochets back into the same so that you can do that turn. So just please, just 1 double crochet in each except for the corners, then put 2, chain 2, and then 2. And I'll see you back here in just a moment when you finish this round. And for those new to crochet, just a recap on the corner is just come right to the edge, okay? So you've got the last one in, and then the corner is just 2 double crochet right in there, and then chain 2, 1, 2, and then back into the same corner for 2. And then you begin to double crochet all the way around. Don't forget, you gotta get that first one in there and then continue along the line, okay? So that's it. It's gonna continue along for round number 4. So I'm coming to the conclusion of this. I got 2 more stitches left. Don't get confused that this one that leans over is actually an extra stitch right there. So make sure that you don't do that. I used to do that for years and I always ended up with the wrong count. So you're just gonna double crochet in the final 2 and then just join it to the top of the chain 3. And once you join it, it actually lines right everything right back up. So that was the conclusion of round number 4. We're now gonna start round number 5. In round number 5, we're going to start an accent round. And the accent round is essentially just a double crochet, chain 1, skip 1, and keep going all the way around. On the corners, what we want to do is just double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in. So we want to keep an eye here that you'll notice here on the outside on the corner that you have a double crochet that is in the last one, chain 1, and then double crochets in the next. So you're not actually skipping anything between these when you're doing this. So when we go to start up, we're gonna chain 4. 3 of it counts as a double crochet. The extra one is considered as a chain 1 space. And when you come back all the way around, you are going to then just put in a chain 1 first and then just join it to the third one up so that it keeps that chain 1 space open. Let's begin. Let's show you how to do this. So let's begin round number 5. We're gonna chain 3. So 1, 2, 3, and then chain 1 more. There's your 4. So that was your double crochet and your chain 1 space. You're going to skip the first double crochet, which is this one right here, and you're gonna go to this one here and you're gonna double crochet. So you're gonna basically as you go along the edge is that you're always skipping 1. So you're gonna chain 1, skip 1, and double crochet into the next. So this will be a really quick round because you're skipping so many stitches. Chain 1, skip 1, and double crochet in the next. So it's gonna create a nice piece. On the final look of this Afghan, when you see it, you'll understand why we're doing this today. Okay, so chain 1, skip 1, double crochet. I'm gonna take you all the way to the first corner and show you what to do there. So chain 1, chain 1, double crochet into the second one over. So you're skipping 1. Very easy round here as you go. So chain 1, continuing along closer to the corner. It'll open right up in the next round of once we get playing with that. Okay, I forgot the chain 1 after that one. So I could tell that it was kind of leaning too close to it. That's how I my visual cue. And then what we're gonna do is chain 1, skip 1, go into the next, chain 1, and look at that. So I'm gonna end up skipping 1. I'm ending up right in the very end. So that means that my counts are correct. Chain 1, and then come into the corner. So double crochet only 1 time, chain 2, double crochet again, in, chain 1, and then come right into the very first one as your starting point, and then again the same thing. So chain 1, skip 1, double crochet in the next, and do that all the way to the next corner, and continue to do that all the way around. So it'll look really kind of weird at this point, but once you get to the next round, it'll open up just beautifully on you. So continue that all the way around. So I'm coming to the conclusion on round number 5. So just chaining 1, and this is the last post in, chain 1, and if you look at it, it's skipping 1, and here is the post for the next one. So I know that it's right. Count the third one up. So 1, 2, and 3. Don't go all the way to the fourth because then you'll accidentally eliminate that chain 1 space from before. So that is the conclusion. You can see it's kind of looking great, and we're gonna move up to round number 6, which is the conclusion of this color for this particular area of your Afghan. So back on the chart once again, number 6, we're going to slip stitch over to the chain 1 space first and then chain up 3, which counts as a double crochet, and then we're gonna just double crochet in each one of the double crochets and chain 1 spaces as we go. When we get to the corner, what we're going to do is then 2 into the corner, chain 2, 2 back into the corner, and continue along. When we get all the way to the end of this one, we're gonna slip stitch and then we're gonna just do a different color just like you did before when we finished off doing the circle. Let's begin round number 6. To begin round number 6, you have to slip stitch to the first chain 1 space first before you begin. So just insert in, pull through and through, and that will shift you over to being over top of that first space, and that's where the designer wants us to be. And it makes a difference, so do that please. So you're gonna chain up 3, and coming into the next double crochet, which is next, is gonna be a double crochet, and coming up to the next chain 1 space is going to be a double crochet. So you're just gonna continue just to double crochet into the double crochets where they're available, and if it's a chain 1 space, then you go into the chain 1 space. And you're gonna do that all the way around, really quite a no-brainer idea. And what we're going to do is when we get to the corner, it's just like we had been before, it's going to be 2 double crochets, chain 2, and 2 double crochets when you go right into a corner. So that's really quite an easy pattern to be able to follow along at this point. And let me take you to the first corner for those that are just new to crochet and aren't sure what I'm saying. Sorry, I don't know any good jokes. Yep. So continuing along, hopefully you're liking this pattern. I'm actually really liking how it's coming together. I'm crocheting this for the very first time as I go, so I'm enjoying the process as well of seeing it come together in my hands. So continuing along here to the corner. It's longer to the corner than I expected, but you know, each round is gonna get progressively bigger, so each round takes a little bit more time to go around. So I'm just really quite a nice pattern to be able to follow with the chain one spaces there. Makes it quite easy instead of worrying about each individual stitch. So you're going to go into the chain one space, and then you're gonna go into the last double crochet before it turns into a corner. Okay, so go into the last one, and now the next one is your corner. So it's gonna be two double crochets, so one and two, followed by chain two, and then one and two back inside that same space to complete that corner. So please do that idea all the way around. See, it looks really kind of cool now. You got an accent round in there, and continue that idea all the way around for round number six. So I'm coming up to the conclusion of this round, and I'm just finishing up the final steps. Remember that we did slip stitch over to the chain one space the first time, so then this one that we technically would have started on before if we haven't done it needs to be filled in. So make sure you get that last double crochet in, and that's it. So you're going to just slip stitch to the top of the chain three, and that concludes off that round. We're now officially done this color at this point for this particular area of the Afghan. We're just going to trim our yarn, and all I'm just gonna do, the next round, if you can see in the pattern, is going to be single crochet all the way around. So you can just safely weave this in and out for about 2-3 inches in, and then when you go to double crochet around, you can trap it underneath. So we got one more round in this particular area before something interesting happens, and that's not until clue number three. So continue just to weave in your ends, and I'll see you back here where we'll start the final round. So finally I'm gonna bring my accent color back up. In my case it was vintage white, and I'm gonna use that now, and I'm gonna just join it to where the top of the last slip stitch was, and then I'm just going to single crochet all the way across. In the corners there's four single crochets that go into this chain two space, and then again single crochet all the way down to the next corner, and so on. Let's move on to round number seven, which is the final of this area of the Afghan. So without creating a slip knot, just loop it around your hand like so, and go into the top of the first one that you started with, just like so, and pull it through. And I want you to leave the straggler down on top of the line so that you can crochet right over top of it. I want you to chain one first, and into the same one that you just inserted in, just single crochet, just like that. Perfect. So now you're just gonna move along to every double crochet is going to get something. Okay, so it's all going to get single crochets. So this is like an accent color. So continuing to move along, so keep going, lay that down on top and get it right underneath. It saves you getting a darning needle in the end, and it will hold it nice and secure as well. So once you get to the corner, don't forget you're going to put in four single crochets right into that chain two space to allow you to turn the corner, and then all you're just going to do then is just single crochet yourself down until you hit the next corner. Once again. So just single crochet all the way across. I'll meet you at the first corner. Just quickly review that, and then I'll see you back here in just a moment. So I'm coming to the first corner. So I'm just gonna go right into the last double crochet that I had, and now it's a chain two space, and you're gonna put four single crochets there. So 1, 2, 3, and 4, and just immediately start on the first double crochet that you hit when you go around, and just start double crocheting down the side as well until you hit to the next corner, and so you'll end up with a beautiful corner just like that. So please continue to do this all the way around. So I'm coming up to the conclusion of this round, just single crochets all the way back to the very beginning, and we're just gonna join it with the slip stitch, and that's it. So this is clues number two. So number one and two are now done on the mystery crochet along. What's gonna happen in clue three? I know exactly what's gonna happen. I think you're gonna love it, and you'll have to join me back here. So please fasten this all the way off, and then join me back here for clue number three as we then progress in making this Afghan. So please make sure that you are weaving in your tails, get them out of the way completely, and so then you've got a nice fresh start for clue number three. So that's clue number two. Week number two is now complete. You gotta get some homework done before you see me for week number three, which is next Monday. We're going to then dive in. So we've gone from a circle to a square. And what are we gonna do next to it? Can't tell you. No, seriously, I can't. No, really, I can't. So you have to join me next Monday and we are going to have a good time. Don't forget about our Facebook events page on Joanne's Facebook, where we're showing work in progress photos. And if you have any questions, we'll try to answer as best that we can. And we are really thrilled to see the creativity that's already happening on that page. So on behalf of Joanne.com, I'm Mikey of The Crochet Crowd. Join me next week as we take our adventure, the next step, which is clue number three. We'll see ya. Welcome back to Joanne.com. I'm your host, Mikey of The Crochet Crowd. We are going for week number three. Yes, clue number three as we go in our mystery adventure together. This is the Bernat Blanket Stitch Along, where we're taking just an idea and going in a mystery path to get to a final Afghan. We're on clue number three, so we're now gonna be 75% done after the end of today's tutorial. So of course, if you're not ready for today's tutorial and you missed the clues, I won't tell anybody. You can just scroll back and get the patterns in order to get week one and week two completed so that you can join me right back here as we do week number three together. Week number three, don't tell anybody, but you can scroll to the end of this video if you really like to see what you're going to be up to today. But of course, if you like to live dangerously, you can just stay right here and hook your way through it and be pleasantly surprised in the end. This is going in a completely different path. So just between us friends, don't tell anybody, it's just our secret. No, seriously, don't tell anybody. Week number three has more work involved than the rest of the other weeks, but week number four is just a polishing off of just finishing it off. It's like the icing on the cake. That'll be week number four. So put in your time this week because next week we're gonna finish it off and you are gonna be totally amazed. So without further ado, let's head down to the studio right now and let's get started. In clue number three, this is what we have done so far. So we have clue number one, which is a circle, and clue number two, we converted the circle into a square. So we've been working in a continuous round to make the entire circle, so we've never had to turn our work and flip it to the other side. Even when doing this square, we continue to do a continuous revolution. So this whole thing that we're looking at right now, clue one and two, we've been working with the right side of the project only, but now the equation's gonna change as we move and do clue number three. So in clue number three, before we even get started on this particular project, we need to flip this over and work starting on the wrong side. So just pretend this was a double-sided sheet of paper and we need to flip the good side over and start crocheting. And if you can just barely see it here, you'll start crocheting on the back side and working your way across like so. And so you'll go back and forth. And when you go then to do the other side of the project, so we're gonna do the top edge first and then the bottom edge second. And then when you do the bottom edge, you're just gonna turn it around, keeping this so that the front side is facing down, okay? So this is still the wrong side. You're gonna start over here like so and work your way across. So you just have to be paying attention to what is the right side and the wrong side, and this matters for clue number three. So what we're going to be doing for clue number three is that we're gonna start on the top edge and work our way up. So let me just draw on this. And so we're just gonna work our way up and create an extension of the stitches for out for a certain length, just like this. You're then going to move to the bottom and you're going to then create the same thing on the bottom. So you're gonna end up with the top edge and the bottom edge each having something extra. And then what we're going to do from that point is that we're gonna start up on the edge and we're gonna work our way around this, building it up so then we continue the color. So by the time if you see the end result at the end of this video, you'll see exactly what we're looking for. So let's continue and I wanna show you the diagrams and what we're gonna be doing today. So here's a cross section of what's gonna happen as we build out. So look at this diagram like it's two parts to this particular section, and it really is two parts. So you have rows 1 through 5. So you're going to start up on the top edge of your square and you're gonna just go back and forth from 1 to 5. Once you have that done, you're gonna repeat rows 2 through 5 once more so that you'll end up with kind of like almost a double section of what you're seeing. It'll only be 9 rows complete. You have to then finish that off and fasten off for the top edge, but for the bottom edge you have to do exactly as shown here and then just stay fastened on. Don't fasten off at the end of yet. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna turn the project around and then we're gonna start working on this as a complete rotation. So this, any part of the clue number 3 is not really a big deal by any stretch. It's just a matter of going step by step. So this is my other sheet. So think about this as being part 2 of clue number 2. So once we get our top edge and our bottom edge all done, we're gonna then go in a complete revolution by choosing. So the very last one, the bottom edge, we're not gonna fasten off. We're simply gonna turn our work and then we're gonna be back on the right side of the project. So we're gonna be back on the front side as we do this whole revolution. So these ones here that have been going back and forth, we're turning our work each time, but these ones here work back in a continuous revolution as you go around and around. So why is there holes in space missing over here? Well, the designer is showing you exactly how the corners are operating over here. So you can assume that what's happening here is the same as over here and the edge down below and the edge down on this side. So just because it's missing here doesn't mean you don't do it. It's just showing you what you need to look for. So if you're not sure what to do here, just look back. And the only thing that's really different is that you don't have to do slip stitching and there's no building up chains when you do a regular corner. The other thing that you need to watch for is right down the side edge. So what we're going to do is in round number 1 we're gonna circle the entire Afghan with single crochets. So let's just follow it here with the fuchsia color and we're gonna come across. So down here you'll notice that you're going into the side of the stitches. Your goal is to make sure that you get 12 single crochets equally spaced from this one section down until you hit that middle square of your piece that you're working with. So you have to equally space 12 and then just go along the square and single crochet into each until you hit the other one. So when you hit the other one, just visualize it like you're coming down and the square is over here somewhere, and then you have to equally space it before you hit an edge. You single crochet across, turn your corner, and then equally space another 12 up here, go across your square, and you'll come back up the other side just like so, and you'll equally space 12 just like that. So it becomes really quite easy to do, and really if anything that could be the hardest round, I don't know. It's really no big deal. Your secret is just to make sure that you end up with 12, because what happens beyond this point matters on that in order to be 12. So as we start to do the crochet nail element 2 number 3 is that this sheet of paper doesn't tell you that this is the right side or the wrong side. That's in the written instructions. So what I want you to do is that we have to make sure that we start this on the wrong side. So what I did for myself is that the first time I ever did this is that I had this laying on my on me as I was crocheting, and what I did is that in order to crochet in the wrong side I flipped this thing over, and then basically if you flip this over and you flip this up to crochet, guess what? You're on the right side still, and that's where I went wrong. So what I have to do is that I have to look at it just like so. So the right side is facing up to me, and now I'm gonna flip up the edge and crochet myself along this edge, which then puts me onto the wrong side, which is exactly where I need to be. So you just gotta watch for that the very first time. Okay, so let's start row number 1. We're only gonna do row number 1 once, and then when we go to do a repeat pattern will be rows 2 through 5. So just be aware of that. So this is going to go across the edge, which is the white that you see here, and so row number 1 will be working way across that, and we just have to be very paying attention to that. So we're just gonna single crochet, chain 1, skip 1, single crochet in the next, chain 1, skip 1, single crochet in the next, and we're gonna do that all the way across. Let's begin. You can refer to this chart as it is available through this pattern if you wish, and we're gonna go through 1 through 5 together right now. So what we want to do is that we need to begin in the third one from the edge. So because I've been crocheting in this direction, I normally crochet in that direction, the third one is from the square or from the corner. So there's 4 stitches in the corner. So it's the third one in because I'm crocheting this way. So if you're left-handed you will see it from a different perspective than what you're seeing here, but it's still the same one. The other thing that you could look at too is that you can see that this is the end one of the 4 and this is the second one over. You can look for the second, but technically in technical words it's the third one over. I'm just going to create just a loop here, slip knot, and I'm gonna insert my hook in and I'm gonna go into the third one like so, and I'm just gonna join it just like this, and I'm going to then chain up 1 and single crochet into the same one, and that'll begin as I go across. So the next one, just like it showed in the diagram, is chain one. You're going to skip one and you're going to single crochet into the next. What I like to do is put this straggler down on top of the line and then get that stuck underneath so it gets really quite trapped quite nicely, and therefore you can bury it. So it's chain one, skip one, go into the next. Chain one, skip one, go into the next. Okay, so when I'm looking in the distance, I should be looking at the right side, okay? Because technically I'm crocheting on this side here, which is the wrong side. Okay, so just do that all the way across. So chain one, skip one, single crochet in the next. I'll meet you on the other side of this corner, or on the next corner, and then I'll show you how to turn your work. So I've come up all the way across and I'm chaining one, and the last one, you skip one and the last one should be in the third one, or sorry, should be in the second one on this side. Okay, so remember what I said is that you have to count the corners as if you're going in the direction that you're crocheting. So it's actually the second one on this side. You can look at it from that perspective, or if you are gonna look at it from the side, then it's the third one up. Either way, it's still the same stitch. So that's how it would look like then for row number one. So you've gone all the way across like so, and now let's turn our work and go for row number two. So let's turn our work, and I don't turn everything over, I just kinda, cause I'm gonna have to turn it back anyway. So I just turn it over just enough so I can access this side. And I'm just going to start off row number two. We're gonna chain up one, single crochet in the first single crochet, and single crochet in the chain one space. So everything is gonna get a single crochet, whether it's a single crochet or a chain one space. Just one each, going all the way down for row number two. I'll meet you at the end of the row. As I come up across and I'm working across on row number one, I'm actually on row number two, but I'm working across on here in row number one. And what I want to do is that strand that we went and buried over top of, you can see it. So what I want to do in this round here is that, or this row, is that I want to make sure that I go around that as well in order to trap that into position so it gets nice and stuck into the stitches. And therefore you'll never have to see it come out of your work. Okay, so just when you get to the end, you'll run into that strand and just make sure that you capture it underneath, and therefore that also then pulls it up and creates that division line that you see right there quite nicely. So it's a great trick without having to pull out a darning needle. So go all the way to the edge, and here's the last one right here, and that is row number two. And let's move along to row number three. So let's turn our work and go for row number three. So coming back to what we were at before. Row number three, we're going to do very similar to what we did in row number one, if not the same, is that you chain one, one single crochet into the first one, and then chain one and skip one, one single crochet into the next. Chain one, skip one, one single crochet into the next. Please do that all the way down the row. So I'm coming up all the way to the edge, okay, chain one, skip one, and look, the last stitch is the last one, so it's good. So I know that I'm on track and on key with row number three. So turn our work and go for row number four next. Row number four, we're gonna start doing some puff stitching, and I'll show you how to do that next. So we're gonna create some beautiful detail, and it's called the puff stitch, and this is row number four. So we're gonna have to come back to and do row number four one more time when we do the repeat patterns 2 through 5. So we're going to chain up two, just like so, and we are going to come into the spaces of the chain one that you see all along here, and those are all gonna be puff stitches. To do a puff stitch, you're gonna wrap the hook and going into the chain one space, pull through, give yourself a bit of slack, you need a little bit, and then wrap the hook going in to the same space, pull through, again give it a bit of slack, and then wrap it one more time going into the same space and pull through. You have all this luxury on your hook, all this yarn, you are needing to now yarn over and pull through all of that, just wiggle your way through it, and being a little bit easy and casual with that instead of being tight will allow that. You're then going to chain one. So that's a puff stitch. So after you've done chain one, you're gonna puff into the next. So you're gonna wrap into the chain one space, pull through, give yourself a bit of slack, pull through, yarn over, going in, pull through. So do that total three times, and then yarn over and pull through all of that. You just have to take your time. You will get used to doing this puff stitching just like that. It's all through now, and then chain one. So I'm gonna do it one more time. So in, okay, so that was one, two, and three. Okay, and now pull through all of that and chain one. Okay, so continue to do puff stitches in the chain one spaces all the way across. So I'm coming up close to the end and I'm puffing all the way down, making sure I'm chaining one in between the puffs, and I've gotten used to doing the puffs by the time I've gotten to this level. I've already done this once before, so it was no stranger to me, but it's one of those techniques where you do have to get used to it each and every time you do it. So I'm gonna puff, and I got one more chain one space left, and I'm gonna puff into that one. And then the very final stitch on this, you're gonna, you're not gonna chain one up to the end of this. You were just simply going to half double crochet into the final single crochet, like so. Okay, so the puff will be resting right up there. Okay, so that's how you complete row number four. Let's move up for round number five, row number five. So let's start up row number five. So we're gonna do exactly what we did in row number three, where we're gonna start skipping spaces again. So this time how we do it on this side is that we're gonna chain up one and one single crochet into the top of the half double crochet, chain one, and then you're gonna go in between the two puffs, just right into the space, and you're gonna single crochet. Chain one, divide and go in between the next two puffs, like so. Chain one, go in between the next two puffs. You get that? Isn't that easy? So just continue to go all the way across for row number four. So chain one, single crochet between the puffs, chain one, single crochet between the puffs. I'll see you on the other side. So I'm coming up close to the end of row number five. Don't forget chain one and then single crochet into the top of the half double crochet. So we have to jump over that last puff to make sure that we keep our pattern consistent. So there is rows one through five. Now we need to repeat rows two through five one more time before we can just fasten this off. This is the top edge. You're going to repeat exactly what you're seeing here for the bottom edge as well, but at the bottom edge you do not fasten off at the end, and then we'll carry on from that point. So let's repeat rows two through five one more time. So let's turn our work and go for row number two. So we go back to the beginning again. So let's turn our work. And we're gonna start on row number two. So when we had to do this before, we were on row number one, which we attached to this piece, but we don't need to worry about that here because we're doing a repeat pattern of two through five. So we skip row number one. So in number two, if you remember, we're gonna chain up one and you're gonna single crochet into the first one, and you're gonna single crochet into the next chain one space, and single crochet in the next single crochet, and single crochet in the next chain one space. So everything across here, the single crochets and the chain one, will each get a single crochet, and please do that all the way across for row number two, and this is the repeat. So I'm coming up to the end of row number two. This is the repeat, going into the final chain one space and then single crochet into the final single crochet. So let's simply turn our work again and let's go for row number three. So in row number three, if you remember, is that we are going to chain one, single crochet into the first one, just like that, chain one, skip one, and single crochet in the next. And you're gonna do that all the way across. So chain one, skip one, single crochet in the next. Please do that all the way across for row number three. So I'm completing row number three, chain one, and single crochet finally into the last one, just like that. So let's turn our work and go for row number four. So row number four, this is a repeat, so we're gonna do the puff stitching once again. Chain up two, and you're going to go to the first chain one space and you're gonna begin to puff. So make sure you take your time doing the puff stitching, giving yourself some extra slack so you don't be too tight, and you're gonna puff, pull it through everything, chain one, and then go to the next chain one space and puff again. And you're gonna continue like you did before, and that was the repeat of row number four. Please do that all the way across. So I'm coming up to the conclusion of the repeat of number four, and I'm puffing into the last chain one space. Do you remember what we did before? Okay, you don't chain one, you just simply in the last single crochet, you're going to half double crochet. So that puff that lines up directly with the outside, just like this. We're gonna turn our work and go for the final row number, repeat number five, and then this side is done, and this is the top edge, and then we're gonna move completely to the opposite, which will be the bottom edge. So let's turn our work, which I've already done, and go for the final of row number five. So final of row number five, we're gonna chain up one, one single crochet into the top of the half double crochet, chain one. You're gonna come in between the next two puffs, just stick hook in there, single crochet, chain one, and go in between the next two puffs.
So this is row number 5. Now because this is the top edge, what I want you to do is that you're going to fasten off. Okay, you're gonna do that completely. And what you need to do then after that is that you need to come back and you need to do the bottom edge. So go completely opposite across and repeat these steps one more time. But at the end of that, do not fasten off. And that's so important because you wanna make sure you're keeping your pattern consistent. It will look different if you're not starting on the right side of the, or if you're not starting properly for the next set of clues. So please continue to do this all the way across. So chain one, single crochet between the puffs. So as I finish row number 5, in the distance, this is the right side of the project. It's facing up, and see how I'm just crocheting along here? I'm actually crocheting on the wrong side right now. That totally makes a difference on the next set of clues when we get to that point, but this is the ending of the top side for me. And then what I need you to do is that I need you to go to the bottom side and repeat exactly what you did. But remember, you gotta look for that wrong side to be your starting point, because if you don't, it will look slightly different from each other if you start on the wrong section. So once I got my last space here, chain one, and then single crochet into the final top of the chain two that you started with there. So that's it for that. That's rows 1 through 5 and then 2 through 5, and this is top edge, so I'm gonna fasten off at this moment. Just as a recap to fasten off, I'm just pulling the loop through, and now because I'm going to be extending around this edge in the future, is that I can just weave this in and out, in and out, and the next time I go around this, I can trap it underneath the stitches in order to make it work. So that's how you're gonna do that. So let's move along to the bottom edge and let's get that done. I'm not gonna film that separately because it's exactly the same steps as you're doing right now, but I will help you get started because I gotta do it myself. So here's the wrong side that I was just working on. So in the distance, it's the right side that's facing up, but then I just flip the edge and I'm just crocheting along. So because I know this is to be accurate to be the wrong side, all I'm just gonna do now is just flip this around 180 degrees and I'm gonna do the bottom edge. And so I'm still looking at the right side up and this edge is now flipped up for me, okay? And I can see that this is the wrong side that I'm looking at right here. So I'm going to start off in this corner here in order to begin. I'm gonna help you get started and then I'm gonna leave the rest for you because you can just follow what I did on the other side. So let's get started. We're gonna do row number 1, one more time, all 1 through 5 and then 2 through 5. So I'm just gonna help you get started. So remember in the corner, it was the third one. So we crochet in this direction here. So there is 4 stitches in the corner. So it's the third one in. And if you're confused, just look for it and it's the second one in. So just 1, 2, 3, there we go. Okay, so I'm gonna just join it. I'm gonna leave the straggler down on top like I did before. And I'm gonna join and chain one and single crochet into the same stitch. Then chain one, skip one stitch, leave this straggler down on top and go right over top of it and trap it underneath because we'll deal with that again like I showed you. And chain one, skip one, single crochet in the next. So chain one, skip one, and single crochet in the next and going right over top of that straggler. So please do this now, and I've now got you started. So you can just scroll back in this video to start and do the repeat pattern, and it's exactly what you learned how to do up here. So the key is to make sure that you start on the wrong side. So the right side should be facing up. Your lip will be like this, and then you can just safely go like that, just back and forth. And I will see you at the end of this. And make sure you do not fasten off. That's one thing that you cannot do. And I'll see you back here when that's done. When I last left you, we were starting the bottom edge, and now I've worked my way out. So now I have the bottom edge done, and I have the top edge done, and now I'm ready to go. So right now, I'm currently looking at the wrong side of the project, and when I look at the middle here, I can see that it's the wrong side for sure. And what I can do now is that I need to turn my work so that we are then going to work on the right side. So the remainder of this Afghan, we're gonna be back on the right side like we were in the very middle when we were working on all of this stuff and into the square. We were working on the right side the whole time. So the remainder of the project will be doing that as well. So just staying on the right side. So let's pull out our chart and see where we are, and then we're gonna begin the revolutions that go around this section. So if you remember, this is the chart, and so we went from rows 1 through 5 and then repeated 2 through 5, so we ended up with the section just like you already have seen on your own project. Now we're gonna go from rows or rounds number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and we're going to go in a continuous revolution now from this point forward even into clue number 4. It's gonna be a continuous revolution. So as we start, we're going to be on the one corner where we have not fastened off on the bottom edge, and just consider this as the start of the bottom edge just so that you're aware of that. And we're going to chain up one, and we're going to put 3 single crochets into the first one, and we're going to single crochet ourselves across the top edge, and that includes into the chain 1 spaces. And then when we come down here, we're going to be on the side of the project, and when we look at the side here, this is the side that there's no stitch work in. It's right here until we hit the box, okay, the big square that's in the front. So what we have to do is that we have to squeeze from the corner all the way to this point 12 single crochets, and then we're just gonna pick up on this box and go all the way down until we hit the other side where this is on the other edge. Okay, so this back on the top edge and then back across. So that's how we're kinda looking at it. So we're gonna come down and we're gonna put 12 single crochets equally spaced, hit the box, and we're gonna go each single crochet, and when you visualize it from this point, the box will be up here. The box meaning the big square, and then you're gonna come and put 12 single crochets in and then hit the corner and then go across and then come back up. So that's what we're gonna be doing now, and we're going to begin changing our colors then in row number 5. The final color is the accent color, and in my case it's been the vintage white as I've been going across as my accent. So let's begin round number 1 and let's start. So let's begin. Remember that you should be looking at the right side of the project, which is right here, and I keep calling it front, but it's considered the right side, and just so that you're aware, so that if you were seeing the wrong side as you're going up this side and you're going across, then you know it's a problem. So make sure that when you look down, it is the right side. It's really important. So let's begin. We're going to chain up 1, and in the top single crochet, the first single crochet that you had, you were going to put in 3 single crochets into that space or into that stitch. So 1, 2, 3. So it's kinda like the corner already, right? So the next one is a chain 1 space, so just go in there, and then the next one single crochet. So I want you just to single crochet in everything going across, so whether it's a chain 1 space or a single crochet, and meet me at the next corner in just a moment. So I've now just come across the bottom edge, and I'm hitting I got another chain 1 space first, and then I got the next single crochet, which is the last one. So in the last one, it's because it's a corner, I'm gonna apply 3 single crochets into that one. So 1, 2, and 3. So now our goal is to get 12 single crochets from this point to the start of this box. So it's just a matter of equally spacing them out. So what I do is I mentally visualize halfway point as being 6, so I'm gonna try to squeeze in 6 to around the halfway point, and then the other 6 to the other point. Sometimes you get it right the first time, other times you don't. You just gotta equally space. So I'm gonna try it here live. So 1, and I just wanna go into some chain work on the outside. I try not to go into massive gaps, because it gets really quite obvious that it's there. You just gotta take your time and just get your stitches in. So this is 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so that's about the halfway point, and now I gotta get another 6 in there. So I just continue to count, make sure I don't get it wrong. So then 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So now I physically have 12 stitches that are in that between the corner never counts. So I got 12 in there, and now I'm gonna jump right into the next empty white one here. Okay, the white stitch on the actual big square, and I'm just gonna continue to single crochet into each one of those stitches, then going to the other side where I'll run back into, so I'm just gonna come down and back around, I'll run back into here, and I'll put in another 12 spacing in there, and then I will, spacing means 12 single crochets in that area, and then I'm gonna turn a corner once again. So I'll see you there in just a moment. So I've been going down the side edge just like so, and I'm about to run out of the white vintage white area, and then I'm gonna hit the side of this here, and this is going toward, this is the top edge going up. So just like I did before, I need to space 12 single crochets between here and the corner. Okay, so let's try and do this one. So we're just gonna try to equally space. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so I'm at around the halfway point, and I'm gonna squeeze another 6 in. So I'm gonna go 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and I've just run out of yarn, so 11, and I'm just gonna join up a new one here. So I'm just gonna join a new piece of yarn here. So this was 11, so I'm just gonna use the new strand and pull it through, and I just gotta put in one more stitch to make my 12. So I'm just gonna leave that straggler down on top and bury it underneath. So now that I got my 12 in here from here to here, I'm now ready for the corner, which is the top of the single crochet. So that's gonna be a total of 3 single crochets in there, and I'm just burying over top of that straggler. So 1, 2, 3. So now we're gonna go along this edge here, and it's just like before, it's got chain 1 spaces, it's got single crochets. So we're gonna start off, and the first one is going to be a chain 1 space. So I'm just looking for it, see where my finger's popping through. So that's the first one. So just 1 single crochet into there, and the next one is a single crochet, continuing to bury over top of those stragglers. Do you notice I'm not freaking out because I'm having to do that? It's not a big deal. This yarn is really easy to hide. It's really quite a great project to work with. So just single crochet yourself across. This is the top edge as we go. So I've now just come across the top edge, and I'm working my way all the way to the corner. So the last one is a single crochet, and so then that one will be 3 single crochets into that one. So 1, and that allows me to turn a corner, 2, and 3. And guess what's next? I bet you know. So now we have to squeeze another 12 between this point and before we hit the white area here of the main square. So let's try to get in 12. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Try and then another. So 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. I've been crocheting a long time, so I can pretty much get it right the first time. So that's 12 in there, and now I hit the first one that's empty, which is in the square, and I just single crochet myself. So I'm now heading back to the side that I have started on, and we're gonna hit that spot before the stitch. So if I just follow it all the way up, we're gonna hit that area, okay, right here, get in another 12, and then I'm gonna join it. So I'm gonna leave this for you, see if you can figure that out, and then I'll see you back here where we'll join. Okay, now that I have my section in, so I've come across, I did this on my own, okay, that you have your 12, and then once you get your 12 in, you just need to join it to the beginning single crochet that you started with right over here. So just stick in your hook and do a slip stitch like so, and now you're ready to go for round number 2. In round number 2, we've done a join at the slip stitch, and what we have to do is that we have to then slip stitch when we start the next round, and go to the middle one of the 3, and then start from there, chain up 1, single crochet in, chain 1, and single crochet into the same one. So just like we had done before where you had skipped over stitches, we're gonna be doing the same thing over here as well. So we're going to just have to watch this ones that are right in the middle, and so we single crochet, chain 1, and go right directly to the next one. So what I want you to visualize is that there's 3 in a row. So let me just show you over here. So there's 3 in a row, okay? So single crochet is in the first one, chain 1, the middle one gets 2 with the chain 1 that separates it, chain 1, and then 1 right in the end. So if you can just visualize how to do that there, it's a lot easier. Let's move along to round number 2. So let's begin round number two. So there's three single crochets in there. We've joined to the first one. So we need to single crochet over one over, and that's the middle one of the three. Just like that. So now we're in the middle. So we're gonna chain up one, and we're gonna single crochet into that same spot that we just did that last slip stitch to. Chain one, and then single crochet back into that same spot again. So there you go. So we're gonna chain one, and just come to the very next single crochet, which is part of that corner, chain one, skip one, and one single crochet into the next. So chain one, skip one, one single crochet in the next, and you're gonna do that until you hit the next corner where I've already explained how the corner looks, but I'm gonna review it one more time with you as I turn the first corner, and then I'll leave the rest of this round for you to do. Okay, as I hit the next corner, I'm gonna chain one and skip one, and I'm in the beginning one of the three. So there's three in the corner, remember? So I'm keeping in count, and it's matching up perfectly, which is good. So you're gonna chain one and go to the middle one. So this one is the one, okay? So chain one, so next one is the middle. Then you chain one and go back into the same one because you're in the middle. Chain one and just go directly to the next one. Okay, that's your three in the corner, and then chain one, skip one, and begin again all the way down the edge. So please do all the remaining corners like that, and I'll see you at the end of this revolution where I'll show you how to fasten off, or sorry, how to finish off this round, and then we'll move on to the next. So as I come back around, single crochet, chain one, and then I'm just going to just join it to the very first one that we had, okay? So the first single crochet in, just like that, and then that finishes off that round. There you go. So let's move on. I'm gonna take you back to the chart, and let's review number three. So let's review number three. Number three is the puff stitching all over again. So what we're going to do with this is that we're going to slip stitch over, and we're gonna get to the middle one, okay, of these here. Okay, so it's in between, just like this. We're gonna chain up two, and then we're gonna puff stitch in, just like that. Chain one, puff stitch into the same one, chain one, and then move up and put in puff stitch and chain one in between every one of the chain one spaces, just like this. What are you gonna do in the corner? Corners are all gonna be the same. It's gonna be puff stitch in, chain one, and puff stitch into the same one when you go to do the corners, just like that. Let's review on how to do this. So let's begin number three. So we've joined on, okay, right where the first single crochet was, and here is where the, see the two are coming into one, just like there, and there's a chain one that separates them. I want you to slip stitch into the chain one, and that'll put you right to where you need to be. You're going to chain two. Doesn't count as anything, it's more of a builder than anything. Coming into the same space, I want you to puff. So you already know how to do that if you've been following along in these tutorial series. So you're gonna do a puff, followed by a chain one. Coming into the same spot, you're gonna do another puff. So the corners are always gonna have two puffs with a chain one that separates them, like so. So just take your time, just kind of, you know, there's no rush. Chain one, and then you're just gonna come in between all the chain one spaces that you see. So here's the first one right here. So it's just right there, so we're gonna puff. Just like that, chain one. Okay, there's the next chain one space right there. So the single crochet, there's a chain one, and just continue to do that. So I'm gonna leave the entire round for you to do on your own. So remember for the corners, as I draw my stitch here, remember for the corners, there's two puffs that separate, are separated with a chain one, and that'll allow you to turn the corners perfectly to keep your Afghan sitting balanced and also sitting flat. So just remember to do that on your corners and filling in all the other chain one spaces with just a one puff each. I think I'm getting more tense or something. It's crazy stuff. So I'm just gonna pull through and then chain one. So again, your tension has everything to do with your success. So I think I need to relax and probably put on a pot of coffee. Okay, we'll talk to you soon, and I'll see you at the end of this round. So I'm coming up all the way back around. Here is the corner where I started, where there was two into the same one. And this round of all the rounds for the remainder of the Afghan is probably the longest that it will ever take you. It's the only time the puff appears all the way around. So I know it's slow, but you know what? You have to have these beautiful stitches in order to really make that pop. So once you get the last puff in, all you just need to do is just slip stitch it to the top of the first puff that you began with. Just like that. Okay, so you ignore that chain two and just go right for the top of the puff. Let's begin to do round number four. So back to number four. So all we're gonna do now is that we're just gonna concentrate on doing what we did before with single crochets and chain ones. In the corners there will be just one single crochet, chain one, one single crochet. That's in between the two puffs that are in the corner, and then we're just gonna go all the way around. This will be the last time you're gonna be using this particular color, because the fifth round is gonna be the accent color, which finalizes clue number three. Let's begin to do round number four. Just before I take you to round number four, you're gonna notice that there's two dots. So when we go to start up round number four, we're going to do a slip stitch over to this chain one space, and then chain one from there and single crochet in, chain one, single crochet in the same one. So right now we're on top of the first puff, so we just gotta move over one. So that's what we're gonna do first. So let's begin to do round number four. So we're just on top of the first puff. Let's just go into between the two, which are in the corner, and we're just going to slip stitch and then begin from there. So we're going to chain one, single crochet in there, chain one, and single crochet back into that same spot. So now the remaining of this side all the way to the next corner will be chain one, okay? And you go in between the puffs like we did down here. Do you remember doing that down there? We're gonna do the exact same thing as we go along the outside edges. So remember, in the corners, in between the two puffs that are in the corner, you're gonna put a single crochet, chain one, single crochet, and then continue to move around. So make sure you please do that for this one. And when we get back all the way around, we're going to fasten off, and we'll do the fifth round together, which is the accent color, and concludes clue number three. So I'm coming all the way back around, and I have the two single crochets in the very corner, and I'm just maintaining the stitch counts that are already there. So now that I'm all the way back around, I've just gotta join it to the beginning single crochet, just like that, to maintain. So this color is officially done for me. I'm going to fasten off, and I'm going to bring back my vintage white accent color in order to do the final revolution, which is single crochets all the way around, except for the corners. We're gonna do three single crochets. So fasten this off. I'm just weaving these in and out, because I know the single crochet, when I go around, is going to trap this into position really quite nicely, and you'll really never see where I stopped and started. So now I'm ready to begin the final revolution of number five. So if we look at number five, all we're just gonna do at this point is that we're just gonna put single crochets all the way around, except for the very corners. We wanna put three into there. So when I fasten on, I'm gonna fasten on in between the two single crochets in round number four that are in the corner. So let's begin to do that next. So starting on the corner, I'm just gonna create a slip knot to begin, insert my hook, and just look for the one that is right in the corner. See how these two are going to the corner? So that's the corner. And I'm just going to slip this on. So just gonna join it with a slip stitch like that, chain one, and then I need to put three single crochets into the same spot. So one, two, and three. So all I'm just gonna do is that I'm gonna move around. So the next one is just a single crochet into the single crochet. The next one is a chain one space. So the chain one space is gonna get one single crochet. So it's kind of like what we've done before, right? So every single crochet is gonna get a single crochet, and every chain one space is going to get a single crochet. And in the corners, we're going to just put in three single crochets right in that corner. So please do that all the way around. I'm gonna leave that in your hands, and I'll see you at the end of this revolution where we'll fasten off together, and that'll conclude clue number three. So I'm coming up to the conclusion of clue number three. It's the final revolution, number five. And this has been pretty good, and it's looking really good. I really like the color selections that I've made for my particular example as well. And everything's working out a-okay. So once we get close to the corner, we're going to do a slip stitch and join it to the very top of the first single crochet that we started with to bring that to conclusion. So there's the chain one space. There we go, and it's the last single crochet. There you go, and then we just join it to the beginning single crochet. So that's it. So I want you to fasten off, weave in your ends, and you can join me then next Monday as we do clue number 4. And again, as I promised, clue number 4 is really no big deal, and it goes really quickly too. A lot quicker than clue number 3. But most of the hard work has already been done, so you're ready to go, and let's see you back here next week.
So that's it for now. You got some homework to do. Better get it done, because clue number 4 is a cinch. It really truly is. So you get this done, you are laughing because clue number 4 is so easy. It's not even funny. No, seriously, it's not. Just between us friends, right? So you're going to join us then next week to conclude week number 4. Your Afghan, it's gonna be ready for gift giving by the end of it. And of course, you can join us on our Facebook events page on Joanne's Facebook in order to share your work in progress and any ideas that you may have. And you will probably be inspired by others' creativity at the same time. So on behalf of Joanne.com, I'm Mikey of the Crochet Crowd. Thank you so much for joining me for week number 3. And we'll see you for the final clue next Monday. And join us right back, right here. Welcome back to Joanne.com. I'm your host Mikey of the Crochet Crowd, taking you for week number 4, the final. This is it. This is the icing on the cake in order to get your Afghan completely done. Hopefully that you are ready for this video. If you are not, just scroll back to the other patterns that we have for clues number 1, 2, and 3 in order to catch up, in order to play along with today's video. In the meantime, for us that are continuing, we've gone now from a circle to a square to a rectangle, and now it's the icing on the cake. It's the final border in order to make all of this work, and this honestly is only 3 rounds that you have to do, and really you can sit back and relax because the hard work has already been done. Just between us friends, if you really want to see what it's going to look like at the end, just scroll to the end of this video, but don't tell anybody I told you that. Just between us friends, remember that. We want to keep that just between us. So you can scroll to the end of the video if you're dying to see, but if, of course, if you like to live dangerously, you can just stay right here, hook along with me, and be pleasantly surprised at the end. Choice is up to you. I'll leave that in your hands. So without further ado, let's go down to the studio and get this thing done.
So welcome to clue number 4. In clue number 1, we did the circle together. Clue number 2, we then converted the circle to a square. And then in clue number 3, we took the square and made it into a rectangle. So in clue number 4 today, we're going to finish this off with 3 rounds in order to do the border. So let's just quickly review on what we need to look for first, and we're also going to review the diagram today as well. So as we start clue number 4, we have to make sure that we're on the right side of the project. So the circle here and the square were both completely done on the right side. So look to that to be your indication. Also, when we finished the final revolutions that we did here in clue number 3, you were also working on the right side as well. So let's look at the diagram and see what we're getting ourselves into today. So here's the diagram that we're going to be involved with today. Now the one in fuchsia here is the 5th round of clue number 3. So it's already been done, so I've highlighted that, so you don't need to do that. So we only have 3 rounds to go. We're going to work in a continuous circle on the right side of the project, and we're going to start off, and we're going to start off just slightly over to the side. So in the very end of number 5, we had 3 double three single crochets right into the corner. So we're gonna move over to 1 over and then chain up 4, which counts as a double crochet and chain 1. And then we're just gonna skip 1, double crochet in the next, chain 1, skip 1, double crochet in the next. And we're gonna do that all the way around. So what we have to pay attention to is the middle one of the 3 in the corner will all be the same in each corner. It will be double crochet, chain 1, double crochet, chain 1, double crochet, all into the same one, which is the middle. We're then going to continue along and do the rest here, and we're gonna move on to number 2, and then finally we're gonna do some front post double crochet as we finish this off to give this a really beautiful look at the end. So let's start round number 1 together. So I'm gonna be looking to the corner. This here that I'm looking at right here is the right side of the project, so this here that you see here is the wrong side. So just remember that. So it's flipped up, so therefore I can move in that direction. So in the very corners there was 3 double crochet or 3 single crochets, so I have to move over to 1 that is just not in that 3. Okay, and that's where we're gonna start today. So I'm gonna create a slip knot just to begin, and I want to pull that through just like that, and I want to slip stitch it to join it just like that, and I'm gonna chain 4. So 1, 2, 3, there's your double crochet, and the fourth is a chain one space. So what I have to do is that I have to come along and I have to skip one and a double crochet into the next one. So I'm just gonna just put that straggler down on top so that it hides it underneath. You can use a sewing needle. I probably actually recommend it because there is a lot of space there. So I'm gonna pull that back out, just a preference. Chain one, and then I'm gonna skip one and double crochet in the next. Then I'm gonna chain one and then skip one, double crochet the next. I want you to do this all the way until you hit the next corner, and I'll meet you there in just a moment. I'll show you how to operate the corners on this one. So now I'm about to hit the middle one of the three, and I'm keeping in balance. I'm chaining one, skipping one, and I end up in the middle. So it's good. So I'm going to double crochet, and then I'm gonna chain one, go back into the same one for another double crochet, chain one, go back into the same one again for another double crochet. That's it. And then chain one, and then skip one, and then start down the next side. So that's how you do a corner. Just really quite easy. So three of them will be all into one as you turn around the corner. So as you come all the way to the final corner, you're gonna chain one, skip one, and then go to the middle one of the three, and you're gonna place a double crochet, followed by chain one, double crochet back into the same one again, chain one, and double crochet a third time back in the same one. Once you have that complete, you've gone all the way around. So I want you to slip stitch to the third one up. So one, two, and three. If you go to the fourth when you started, then what's gonna happen is you're gonna miss out and not get that chain one gap that you need. So you're gonna fasten off at this point. So you're gonna slip stitch and then fasten off and then weave in your ends, and then we're gonna carry on with round number two. So let's move along to round number two. So we fastened off at the third one up, and we're right here, and we're gonna fasten on a new color right on that same spot, and we're gonna chain up three, which counts as a double crochet, and then we're going to double crochet into the same one. We are not gonna chain one or anything like that, but we're gonna put two double crochets into each one of the double crochets that are going each all the way around, except for the corner. So the corner, the middle one, okay, so you see that there's two in this one, and then here's the middle one, and here's the other one that's part of the same corner. And what we have to do is that we have to put a total of six double crochets all into that one. So it's a lot going in on that, but it makes sense because on the final round, as you can see, there's no increasing at all. We're just gonna follow it all the way around. So let's begin round number two. So again, as I mentioned, we're working on the right side completely with this one as we go all the way around. I'm gonna create a slip knot to begin. And what I need to do is that I need to fasten on to the one right after the corner. So this is the corner, you see three. So I wanna fasten in at the top of this one here. Okay, so just join it with a slip stitch and chain three. So one, two, three, that counts as a double crochet. Into the exact same space, I want you to place another double crochet in. So we're just gonna move along the edge. So we're gonna come and do this corner at the end. So we're just gonna move along the edge, and just every double crochet is gonna have two double crochets this time. Okay, so there's chain one spaces that separate them. Don't worry about those chain one spaces, just play within the double crochet. So just put two into each one, and I'll meet you at the first corner, and I'll show you how to turn the corner, and we'll carry on from that point. So I'm now approaching my first corner and pretty excited about it. This is the second last round that we have to do, and again it's still continuing to be double crochet in each of the double crochets, skipping over that chain one that is in the row below. So I'm looking for the corner, and the corner is pretty easy to tell because there's three double crochets that lead into the corner just like so, and there's a double crochet that separate, or it's chain one that separates them. So in the first one of that, we're gonna just put in two as normal. So one and two. So the middle one of the three, that's the one that's gonna have six. So you're gonna put six double crochets in there. So one, two, and three. And just for your information, that third one is the one that kind of makes it go diagonal. So that's kind of like the halfway point when you look at it from this perspective. And then the other three are just a polishing off going around the corner. So this is number four, five, and six. So that gives it that 90 degree turn that you need, see? Isn't that neat? So we're gonna skip to the next one. Okay, so this is the third one of the three, and that one's just gonna have two in as normal. So what I want you to do is that I want you to continue to go around all the way back to the start, and I'll meet you back there. Remember, we have the final corner to do once we get back up there as well. So I'll see you back there in just a moment. As I come all the way around, this is where I've started, so now I'm just gonna finish off. So this is where I woven in my last end, and I'm just gonna go right over top of it so that it gets stuck underneath, so I don't have to sew that in later. So when I go into the stitch, I just wanted to make sure that I go right in over top of it. So what we have here in the corners, just like before, there's three. I just went into the one of them, of the three. The middle one of the three is again going to get six, and I'm making sure I'm going right over top of that woven in end as well. So this is 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So 6 all into that one, and then I jump to the final one of the three, and there's gonna be 2 in that one, and that brings me right back to the very start. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna join this to then the top of the beginning chain 3 that we had started with, and that concludes that round. So I'm just gonna weave, fasten that off, weave in the ends, and we're gonna do the last round together. So now because I've went over this woven in, whatever else is sticking out, I can just cut it right down, and you will not even see it once I adjust it. And of course I can always clean that up better as well. So I'm just gonna weave in this end, and I'm gonna begin the final revolution for clue number 3, which is the conclusion of the Afghan. Finally, we're ready for the third round, which is the conclusion of today's Afghan. So everything is gonna be done once you get this round done. So you're going to join exactly where you slip stitched before, and then you're gonna chain up one and single crochet into the same one. The next one is gonna be a front post double crochet. That's what those symbols mean. Remember, the stitch key is available, and I also hand wrote it out here as well. So every other stitch basically is a front post double crochet. The next one is a single crochet. So you're going to look at it and see that there's two side by side. The first one will always be single crochet. The second one will always be the front post double crochet. It does a really nice three-dimensional look. So when you're really going to look at these things, see there's two. So the first one will be a single crochet. The second one will be a front post. So how we do the front post is that we come in from the side and then pop out through the side, you put your yarn through, and this makes this pop, and it has a really great texture. So let me show you how to do the final round of number 3. Still continuing to look at the front side here. So this here's the back side. So this is the front. When I go to flip it up, and I go to work all my way through it. So I'm just going to create a slip knot, and I'm going to begin. So I'm going to begin, and you're gonna see a corner. So you have your 6. You're gonna see there's 2 here, and then these 2 are where we started. So it's the first one of these 2 is where we started and stopped, if you remember. So that's the one I want to join to. So it's the first one of the 2, and I wanna just affix it with a slip stitch, chain up 1, and single crochet into the same stitch. I wanna make sure I go right up over top of this straggler as well. So just single crochet. So the second one of the 2 is always gonna be a front post double crochet. So wrap that hook going in through the side of the stitch, okay, and then yarn over, pull through, and then pull through 2 and 2. And I'll show that again as well. So here's the next 2. The first one will always be single crochet. Go right up over top of that straggler to hide that. And then the next one of the 2 is a front post double crochet. So wrap the hook going in through the side, back out, yarn over, pull through 2 and 2. Do you get that? So the next one is of the two, the first one is always gonna be a single crochet, and the second one will always be a front post double crochet. So you're gonna do that all the way around. There's nothing fancy to do on the corners. You're simply just going to do this all the way around. Everything is in groups of 2 as you work around. So remember, even the ones in the corner, there were 6, remember? So you have 2, 2, and 2. So do that all the way around, and I'll see you back here in just a moment. We'll conclude today's Afghan off together. So I'm coming all the way back around, including the final corner. Remember, we're not doing anything special in the corner. We're just continuing to do that same pattern of just single crochet and front post double crochet all the way around, and it's actually been pretty good. So I'm on the conclusion of this whole project. I'm really quite excited about it, to be honest with you. I love this Afghan. It turned out really nice, and I think the different color options that people will come up with too will be amazing. So once you get back all the way around, your last one will be a front post double crochet if you're keeping balance, and then you're just gonna join it to the top of the first single crochet that you started with. Now here's the thing. If you weave in your ends right now, they're gonna fall out. So you have to make sure that when you're going to conclude your final Afghan here, we wanna leave enough on here so that we can put it within a darning needle. So let me show you what I'm gonna do with that. So I'm gonna pull this through here first, and I'm gonna grab a darning needle that I have conveniently on the side here, and I'm gonna feed that through. So the secret to using the darning needle or any kind of fastening off techniques is that if you go in and out of a project 3 times, you can hide in the yarn and it will never fall out. So you're just gonna glide it in, goes in like butter. So you just go in and see, it's really not on the other side at all, and just kind of pull it through. When you go to pull it through, you don't want to be reefing on it too hard. You want it to keep its shape, so you just be snug about it, and then you're just gonna go back in the other direction in a different path though, because if you go in the exact same path it'll come out. So going in the other direction for number 2, again just kind of be snug about it, but not like you're tying down a boat, and then finally go back in the third direction and come out. And what you can do at this point is that you can safely just trim it right down to the project and you will never see where you stopped. Isn't that cool? So that's how you conclude today's Afghan. Let's go back up. So that's how you conclude today's Afghan.
Wow, we are completely done our mystery crochet along. We have solved the mystery together. Congratulations to you for finishing. Hopefully that you enjoy your new Afghan. Amazing, isn't it? It's amazing how colors can play together. You have probably been very inspired from the events page on Joanne's Facebook on all the different elements that you've been able to see for color ideas that other people have done at the same time. On behalf of my friends at joanne.com and myself, Mikey of the Crochet Crowd, we would like to sincerely thank you for trusting in us in doing a 4-week Afghan mystery with you. It's kind of nerve-wracking as sometimes you're thinking, oh, the Afghan's going in a really weird direction, and then it all of a sudden comes in a direction you love. It's one of those things with mysteries that it can either go one way or another. We hope that you've enjoyed the inspiration by others on the Facebook events page by Joanne, and we love to hear from you and your creativity. So if you'd like Joanne to do another one, just leave a message on their Facebook page saying what you liked about this, and if you have any ideas for other future mystery crochet adventures, of course we would like to hear from you as well. So until next time, I sincerely again like to thank you on behalf of the Crochet Crowd as well as joanne.com for joining us for the last 4 weeks. Until next time, have a great week, and we'll see you again real soon. Bye-bye.